Hello guys, so far in the chapter DC power supplies we have covered these topics. In case if you miss these topics, the links are available in the description. Today we will learn the necessity of voltage regulation and how a Zener diode can be used as voltage regulator. So let's start with the topic necessity of voltage regulation. To maintain a constant voltage across the load, voltage regulation is necessary. To get a stable output, we need a voltage regulator, and hence we are using voltage regulator at the last of the power supply so that the output of filter will be stabilized, and hence for a good power supply, a voltage regulator should provide good line and load regulation. As in the previous lecture, we have learned the characteristics of power supply, in which we have learned about the line regulation and load regulation. In case if you have any doubt regarding the line and load regulation, you can refer the previous lecture. Now, next move to the next topic. How a Zener diode can be used as voltage regulator. As we know, the output of an unregulated power supply does not have a good voltage regulation. The DC output voltage changes with the change in the AC input voltage, and the output voltage reduces when the load is connected to it. To obtain a constant DC output voltage, a Zener regulator is connected between the output of the filter and load. The Zener regulator is also known as shunt regulator. Now, shunt means parallel, and here we go. The Zener diode is connected in parallel with the load resistor, and hence this regulator, this voltage regulator where we are using Zener diode, is also known as shunt regulator. The Zener regulator consists of a current limiting resistor RS, a Zener diode which is connected in reverse bias as N end of the diode is connected to positive and P end of the diode is connected to negative. The RS is connected in series with the power supply, or we can say output with the filter. The Zener diode is connected in shunt with the load resistor. Mostly the load resistor is variable type resistor. The current from input source, or we can say the current from filter, let's suppose that the current from power supply is IS and the voltage across this is Vs. So Is, by using Kirchhoff's current law, at any terminal or junction, the incoming current is equal to outgoing current. So here the incoming current is Is and outgoing currents are Iz and IL. So we can say that Is is equal to Iz plus IL, as at this terminal Is is incoming and Iz and IL is outgoing. So we can say that Is is equal to Iz plus IL. Now if I want to calculate the particular value of Is, so I will apply the loop analysis in this loop where Vs, Is, Rs and Vz is included. Here Vz is the voltage across the Zener diode. So what I get, Vs is equal to Is Rs plus Vz. Now if I want to calculate the value of Is, I will transfer this Vz to this side. So I will get Is Rs is equal to Vs minus Vz. And from here, Is will be calculated as Vs minus Vz upon Rs. Now, in previous lecture, we learned that for a good voltage regulator or for a good power supply, the line regulation and load regulation should be minimum, or we can say that A power supply should provide good line and load regulation. So let's see whether this Zener diode, which we are using as voltage regulator, is able to provide a good line regulation and load regulation. So first we will see about the line regulation. Now, if the input voltage Vs increases, here it is, the voltage drop across the resistor Rs is Vs. So in case if this Vs, or we can say this Vs voltage across these terminals, is increases, current the Zener diode passes a large current so that extra voltage is dropped across Rs. Now how? As we know that from the characteristics, VI characteristics of a Zener diode, as our Zener diode is connected in reverse bias, so this is the VI characteristics of Zener diode, this during forward bias and this during reverse bias. Now during reverse bias, when up to a certain voltage level, it passes a constant current, but once this level cross, so after this, at this knee point, this is known as knee point. Now once a limit reaches to knee point, you can say it was a straight graph of current. So in this manner, if voltage increases, if Vs increases, the Zener diode passes a large current so that extra voltage is dropped across Rs. A large current is passed after this knee point, and hence we can say that once the voltage increases, the large current is dropped across the Zener diode, and at the output the voltage remains constant because the maximum voltage or maximum current is passed through the Zener diode. The maximum current passed through the Zener diode, and at the IL or at the load resistor, we are getting the constant output. If Vs decreases, in case this Vs decreases, if Vs decreases, Is also decreases, and the voltage drop across Rs is reduced. As Vs decreases, a constant current will flow through the Zener diode, so the remaining current will flow through IL, and in both the cases the output voltage V0 is remain constant. Now let's see about the load regulation. When the diode operates in its breakdown region, Vz remain constant even though Iz is falling through it. Now here it is, when Iz is falling, the Vz is remain constant. After this, there was no current flow here. So when Vz is Vz remain constant even though Iz is falling through it. Iz is flowing through it. If load current IL increases because of reduction in load resistance, Iz falls by some percentage in order to maintain a constant current Is. Now, we suppose that the load value is less. So, according to the current's theory, or we can say the property of current, current flow follows the minimum resistance path, so maximum current will occur here, and hence this thing will not happen. The maximum current will drop through the Zener diode, as this knee voltage or this knee point is very small, so that maximum current will flow through here and this IL will be reduced. In that case, Is remains constant, and when Is remains constant, the Vs will also remain constant, and we get the output V0 remains constant. This kept the voltage drop across Rs constant, and hence the output voltage V0 kept constant. Similarly, if IL decreases, IZ increases so that IS is kept constant and the output voltage does remain constant. In this manner, we saw that a Zener diode is able to provide a good line and load regulation when it is used as voltage regulator. That's all about the today's lecture. In next lecture, we will see the working of voltage regulator using series pass transistor. Also, we will obtain the expression for output voltage and we will see the limitations of series pass transistor when it is used as voltage regulator. Thank you.